If you guys would like cheap FIFA 16 Ultimate Team coins or PlayStation and Xbox codes, check out IG Vault, link in the description. Of course, do not forget to use the discount code in the description for 5% off. Hey guys, Footy Manager TV here. Welcome to episode number 24 of my Manchester United FIFA 16 career mode series. And you can see today we have some crucial games, but look at that. We have two games within 3 days. But apart from the Man City game, they're definitely all winnable games. We did lose that game against Everton previously. Hopefully we can turn it around, start winning games again. Don't forget, we've got like 3 games in hand to Chelsea, who's eventually overtaken us. Obviously not by much, but we're still having the fitness trouble. We've got Marquinhos with a red card right now. We still got Luke Shaw injured, Laporte injured as well, so we're missing a lot of players. But West Ham, I'm going to be looking at this like we're still playing a pretty strong team. There's not too many lower conditions in the team, but what I'm worried about is the next game, which is 2 days later against Manchester City, one of the hardest games of the season away from home against Man City. So, and they want to try and win. They obviously still have a chance to win the title themselves if they beat us, but we got to see if we can get a victory here today against West Ham. So 20 minutes in here, Memphis Depay is looking to trick past the defense. As he does, he tries the finesse shot, but it is saved by their keeper, Adrian. He's a pretty decent keeper, I reckon. West Ham obviously doing pretty well in real life. And that was head up, but goalkeeper saved once again. So not too much action there in the first half. And now West Ham with a chance through Lanzini. And then it finds its way to Ener Valencia as he makes it 1-0. Hopefully this is not a sign of things to come, because we're on a really bad run at the minute. And it's a bit of unluckiness and also, yeah, the fitness troubles as well, which is obviously affecting us. But when you concede a goal like that, it's nothing, just pure unluckiness. Nothing more than that. But here, Michael Carrick is going to step up. What a hit in the 80th minute, as it looked we were going to face another frustrating game. He pulled that out of nowhere. He wants to end his Manchester United career with a league title win, and I want to get it for him. He steps up. What a way to score his only goal for the season in the league. How about that? That's a special hit. Goalkeeper stood no chance to save that. Michael Carrick is like thinking to himself, all these attacking players like Memphis have had chances in today's game. And then, yeah, he just thinks he'll just step up. So we're into injury time now. We obviously escaped, so I was pretty happy, yeah, with just getting a point here away from home. Obviously, you want to be looking for 3 points, especially this stage in the season. There's only 2 more episodes. Next episode is going to be the final episode of games. 3 games in today's episode. And maybe I'll do another one later today, we'll see. But the next episode will be 3 more games. That'll be it for the season. But in this game, again, we did create more chances. You saw that off the stats. And they just had one really good chance. It wasn't even a good chance. It was just their only chance. That rebounding goal, the parrying from the goalkeeper, which is always frustrating. But this is what I mean. We're going to this Man City game with this kind of conditions in our players. We've got suspension over as well. But Man United, we're going to motivate. I'm going to do my job as a manager, try and get the lads up for this game to win it here. And this, a win here could change it. Like, a loss and a win will change a lot for the rest of the season. But look at all the players in low condition. All my players that were starting were almost on half fitness, apart from, I think it was Marquinhos, because he was coming back from that suspension like I mentioned. But everyone else was almost half fitness, which is crazy. That was the situation. But like I was going to say, a win here could put us in a great position to win the league, but a loss could put us in a very disappointing position. Like, the players' morale will be down and will make it even harder to win games. And look at the team we're going in with, like all the low fitness, so it's going to be very, very hard. Though, we started the game okay. We were creating chances. Man City weren't doing so much. So we're getting forward, of course. Look, Navas with a chance here, but we're able to block it, you know. Look at that. Chris Smalling, he's done very well, but this is the thing. Ashley Young with an injury already, but he's just playing on. He's trying to do the best he can. This is what we got to, the players, they have to do their best. And Philippe Anderson maybe could score, but finesses it straight at Hugo Lloris. If you didn't know, Man City signed him, which is forcing, yeah, it's forcing Joe Hart out of the squad, which is Yeah, pretty insane for Joe Hart not to be starting at a team. But yeah, to have one player injured already and that very disappointing slide tackle. I know it looked terrible and yeah, it was very bad defending and yeah, probably deserved to be conceded a goal. But I felt that's really disappointing. Like you make one error and you automatically pay for it, which is very, very annoying. I just tried to take him out there. Maybe I could have even got a red card for that. But I knew if he got passed, it would have been a strong chance for him to score because, yeah, Raheem Sterling's pay. So, yeah, it was a bad attempt to slide. But what can you do? It's done and dusted, and they make it 1-0, and it could be proved to be a bigger goal than it is. Like, it could be deciding we might not win the title now. We may struggle for the last few games. But what can you expect with the fitness? And, yeah, I'm going to probably title this as well. I had to play 2 games in 3 fucking days. What's that? I'm sorry. I usually don't get mad, but what's that rubbish? You play 2 games in 3 days. Really? What do you expect? I apologize, but, yeah, I was trying to, yeah, not get the let my frustrations get the better of me, but yeah, that really annoyed me when I was playing the game because we weren't at our best for this game here today. And again, Anthony Martial, he just took forever to take that shot. I'll let you know, like, I pressed the shot button way before he attempted to shoot it in the game. Just the fitnesses are affecting our players so much, and it's really disappointing. Like, maybe I didn't manage my team the best this season to make sure this time in the season our players are fit enough. And look, just those passes as well, that kind of stuff. Yeah, we were just making those passes earlier in the season because, yeah, fitness wasn't a problem. But yeah, like I was going to say, maybe I didn't manage the team better, didn't rotate enough. But when you play 2 games in 3 days, what are you expecting? You're forced to not start Lacazette and you have to start someone like Martial instead. And it affects you, like you saw in this game so far. And with Ashley Young getting injured early, it's very disappointing. But here, Schneiderlin, again, it's another poor pass. Do you call this assisted passing? Man, it's very frustrating. Now, this young talent for Man City, Hanaccio, I'm really not sure how to say his name, but I think he's got decent potential in FIFA 16 career mode if you wanted to maybe sign him. Yeah, he'd definitely be an alright player. He's not the best option out there, but he's pretty decent. He was through there, but he takes out Chris Smalling, and he actually finished there, I think. But yeah, it was a free kick against him. Daley Blind picks up a yellow card there. But now Memphis, we may have a chance here. Look, it's like 3 against 1 almost. Play it across, no company gets in the way. It's another situation, and look, Schneiderlin picks up an injury there as well. So it's absolute craziness what's happening right now. We've got 2 injuries, fitness is depleted. Look, Schneiderlin, he's almost falling down, like he's on his leg there, putting pressure on it, because he can't walk, he's hobbling. And that was when we were trying to get a late goal. And the thing is, we had 6 shots on target here. They had 1. Again, 1 good chance, and they took it. Oh, and really, I'm so frustrated about that. Like, oh, we should not be in this position for multiple reasons. I felt we actually played better despite getting 2 injuries during the game, much lower fitness, and we're still in an okay position. That's the crazy thing. We win that extra game in hand, and we're still first. It's so close. And yeah, coming from the last episode as well, something I noticed, basically every single episode before the last episode, people were telling me I should play in Legendary because I was winning so much. And now one episode, like in yesterday's episode, people were saying I was crap at the game because of one episode, like a couple losses. So I suppose that will be even worse now in this episode. But yeah, that's YouTube. So like, that's, and I said it in that episode as well, people really are reactive to a couple results. I win a couple games in a row and it's too easy, and I lose a couple games and I'm crap. But yeah, I think it's funny anyway. But look at all the ratings. Like the fitness, how am I supposed to play? How am I supposed to play properly? I'm starting Logan, and look at Damian, low condition Rooney, and there's something I want to talk about starting Logan. He's really good on the ball. Look at that. Look at that short pass there compared to other passes in this episode. That was really, really nice. And some people are wondering why I'm not starting Nick Powell instead, as Memphis has a header chance there pretty hard. And even there, Memphis couldn't blast away with his pace as he would have done earlier in the season. But this time, Juan Mata is getting past. Look at that dribbling. Oh, and you've seen that earlier in the season from Mata. I think he scored a couple goals like that, where he's weaving in and out with the dribbling, but he just couldn't quite do it there. The finish wasn't up to scratch, and Damian, I'm not sure what that is. I've had a few chances with Damian this season, but he's got a very, very poor shot on him, regardless of how straight you try and aim and how, the best you can aim. But yeah, he just blazes it wide every single time, which is very frustrating. But here, Lacazette, he finds Memphis, then Memphis to Juan Mata. And can we finally get a win? Please. And I was trying to do that celebration there with Juan Mata, like, I know what it's called. But trying to, like, get his ear, listen to the crowd, because I felt I was under a lot of pressure here. I felt I was under a lot of pressure to get the result and to get the win. And you had no idea, after I scored that, like, I had so much on my chest there. I was trying to, like, so much pressure. And I was like, finally. Like, it took so much effort to score that goal, because I know I keep repeating it, but it is the problem, the fitness. And here, Logan again, he takes a shot there, never looked like scoring, but he, even though he's like only 53 rated, he feels good on the ball. You saw the pass he played before, and I was leading to say before about here not playing Nick Powell. Someone said, like, why would you play a 53 rated player and not play Nick Powell? But that's the difference. Nick Powell is not a youth player with high potential. He's got really, really poor skill attributes and not high potential, like someone, high potential youth scouts. And here, a very big mistake. And if you look at the replay, that led from a free kick we had, and I tried to play it straight to my player, but no, it didn't go straight to my player. I know passing in FIFA can be very frustrating, and it's, my frustrations are boiling over now because it's clearly affecting us. But this game, we were able to get it done. A win. I felt we needed this. We needed this because then we should take that top position back. We needed the 3 points. And again, we restrict our opponents to only one shot on target. So I believe I'm still playing well considering the circumstances, without a doubt. I think personally I'm playing well. So now, we are still that 1 point away, but we've got a game in hand to Chelsea. So I still think we can win the title. It's going to be so close. It's going to be closer than I would have liked, though. But perhaps that's a good thing as well. Like I said, because I'm really happy with playing on world class, and I don't want to really go to legendary. So almost in a way, I'm kind of happy that I'm losing games, so people can see world class is not too easy. But look at George Gibbons, 59 overall for 15 years old only. I reckon he's going to be that type to replace Michael Carrick. We've got a really good youth squad here. Leave your thoughts on it right now. Who do you think is going to be the players of the future? But again, that's something that may potentially annoy me as well. I talked about a bit on Twitter the other day. So maybe if you're following me, you would understand how youth players, some of them, their contracts, they just leave. They leave the first team, or they leave the U squad without asking. You know how when they say they want a contract? But some players leave when you don't even get that message. But yeah, you're going to see that coming as well. So over the last day or so of playing FIFA, a lot of frustrating things have happened. But I'm pretty good at working past that, and we have a good opportunity to still win the title here. I want to show, Stoke City already relegated along with Watford. Going to be tied with Crystal Palace, Aston Villa. Oh, look at the tie at the bottom of the table. How about that? I like when seasons are like that in real life as well, when it's really close at the top and close at the bottom. Like, a lot of teams could potentially get relegated. And obviously, there's no real fight for a Champions League now, so, like, the fourth position or something like that. But I'm just going to end this episode on a squad report. Again, I hope you understand. I really wanted to get across how frustrating those games were, and much different than earlier in the season. And I really wish someone could have seen and try to play how I was playing. The conditions I had to play in, because it was so frustrating. Leave your thoughts. Have you ever had that in FIFA? Like, later in the season, like, it actually felt really, really hard. You're playing on the same difficulty, no changes, but the games just feel harder. I don't know. But yeah, leave your feedback. Like I said, second last episode of the league season. Last episode. I'd like to get out later today. Drop a like if you would like to see that. Subscribe if you are new. And I'll see you guys in the very next episode.